2018 and newer Chevy Equinox and GMC Terrain rear brick replacement. It is critical that you remove the master cylinder reservoir cap when you do that. And also you will need a dealer level skin tool for the rear brakes in service mode. Alright. I already have the vehicle in service mode. Okay. I'll post the link in the comment section for a skin tool to use to do this. Let's start by compressing the caliper. There it is. Okay, caliper fully retracted. You see the piston all the way in. Now let's remove the water returning screw. Is it seated already? All right. Let's take out the caliper bolt. It is held by 230 millimeter. I recommend you to use a 21 millimeter like this one to hold the pin in place, and a 30 millimeter so you can take it off. All right, got both of them off. There it is. Let's take the caliper off and put it on the side. Perfectly fine right here. Now let's take out the caliper bracket bolt. It is 280 millimeter, one here, and there is one further down. I don't know if you guys can see it, near the CV axle. So I'm using an extension, about 16 inches extension, and it is 380 millimeter to get the caliper bracket bolt off. Here it is. The one at the bottom, there was a hole right here. You put switched to the shutter extension and the deep 18 millimeter and a swivel, so I can remove the lower bracket bolt. And you can use the same method to remove the top bolt too, by the way. All right, it is loose now. I'm gonna be replacing the pads, the hardware, and re-grease them. Okay, take the old hardware off. We need to clean the channels here with a wire brush. A wire brush like this. Clean it up. Alright, both pin with grease. Now that I have the old water off, let's clean the hub. You can use the wire brush, it would work perfectly fine too. So you can get off of the surface cloth. We got the new water in. Let's put our water retaining screw in now. Good. Now I clean the channels. Let's put the brake hardware in. Sit just like this. Good. Here they are. Let's run the bolt hole with the gun again. Here's what it looks like. Here's our brake pad. We put a little bit of grease off each end of the brake pads. Right. Brake pad number one. Perfect. Brake pad number two. There it is. Perfect. We got it in. So now let's put our brake caliper in. There it is. Let's put our bolt in. Bolt number one. Bolt number two. Good. So there it is, guys. Everything is back together. Caliper is moving freely. It's good to go. Don't forget to pop your brakes before you go for a test drive. And put your reservoir cap back on. And reset the parking brake with your skin tool. You should be good. Thanks for watching, guys. See you on the next one.